کار نکنی یا مثلا به جامعت خدمت نکنی، به اسلام خدمت نکنی. یه نوع ایثار تو بسیج هست که حالا اون مثلا درجه بالاش میشه همون که شما مثلا شاید باش مواجه شده باشین، که مثلا ما تو میدانهای جنگ حتی مثلا اون بسیجی حاضر میشه برای مثلا مردمش، برای مثلا عقیدهش و برای اینکه از مثلا میهن دفاع کنه جانش رو هم بده. این میشه مثلا نقطه مثلا عالی بسیج کنه. یعنی اون مثلا جوون آمریکا اگه بخواد مثلا بسیج رو مثلا بشناسه، نه بیاد عکسای زمان جنگ رو ببینه یا مثلا ببینه زمان جنگ چه عملیاتایی شده، چه اتفاقایی افتاده. الان باید بیاد تو عرصه‌های علمی مثلا مملکت ما هم ببینه که اگه ما داریم به انرژی هسته‌ای میرسیم، مثلا باز مثلا تفکر بسیجی پشت کاره که یه ملتی بدون هیچ سابقه‌ای، بدون مثلا کمک از هیچ کشوری به یه تکنولوژی برسه که همه ابرقدرت‌ها بخوام مثلا باهاش مبارزه بکنن که اینو ازش بگیرن.
هدفمون البته این هست که جلوی تجاوز متجاوز به خاک کشور ایران رو بگیریم در ظاهر، اما هدفمون هدفی بالاتره. هدف ما حرکت دادن جهان به سمت معنویته. ما می‌خوایم جهان رو عوض کنیم و جهان رو به طرفی ببریم که از زیر همه بندگی‌ها بیاد بیرون کل جهان، آدمای جهان، و برن زیر بندگی خود خدا.
من یه حرفی که شما زدین رو خیلی میتونم هم درک کنم، هم میتونم بگم که پس اگه شما اینو میگین، این کسایی که میگن که ایران اگه مثلا به نیروی هستی برسه یا به جای برسه که قدرتمند بشه، با یه همچین ایده‌ای که شما الان گفتی، با همین ایده‌ای که شما الان گفتین، چطور میتونیم مطمئن باشیم که مثلا کشور ایران نخواد به زور دنیا رو به طور معنویت اونطور که خودش معنویت رو میبینه بکشه؟ میدونی چی میگم؟ این ایساگرایی و این که مثلا دنیا رو از یه بند آزاد کردن به بند خدا نزدیک کردن، یا آمریکایی که نشسته یا مسیحیه یا بی خداست یا هرچی، برای چی؟ اون چجوری شما با اون حرف میزنید؟ چجوری نترسه از حرف شما؟
ما نمیخوایم همه همون چیزی همون جوری فکر کنن که ما فکر میکنیم. اصلا مهم نیستش همون جوری فکر کنن که ما فکر میکنیم. ما میخوایم آدم ها زیر سلطه غیر خدا نرن.
اگه بخوان برن چه اون وقت؟
اگه بخوان برن اون وقت دیگه انتخاب خودشونه.
اما چه وجود داره؟ حالا من تو میخوام تحکیم میکنم حرفو. صادر کردن اون چیزی که آمریکا بهش میگه فرهنگ به کشورها، با صادر کردن اون چیزی که مثلا مردم ایران میخوان مثلا به کشور دیگه صادر بکنن، یه فرقی هست. و مثلا مردم عراق که آزادن تصمیم بگیرن چه فرهنگی داشته باشن، چه تمدنی داشته باشن، چه حکومتی داشته باشن، با فشار این چکمه های مثلا سربازی آمریکایی باید به اون چیزی که اونا فکر میکنن فکر بکنن، ما اونجوری نمیگیم. نه، ما به اون اعتقاد نداریم. ما اعتقاد داریم آمریکا الان داره اون کارو میکنه، به زور آدما رو وادار میکنه که تو همونجوری فکر کن که من دارم فکر میکنم.
These guys seem surprised at the idea that they're seen negatively by other Iranians. For them, Basijis are serving their countrymen by defending them and by providing all kinds of social services.
خب چیزایی که من گفته میشه و میشنوم درباره رول بسیج در جامعه چیزای خیلیش مثبت نیستش.
من واقعا دیدم مردم چی فکر میکنن در مورد بسیج. موقعی که مثلا پدر مادرها از این که میبینن مثلا بچه‌هاشون میان یه جا، یه آدمی هستش که مثلا حالا خودش توی یه سطحی از درس خوندن و سواد و اینا هستش، میاد به بچه‌هاشون شب امتحان 12 ساعت از روزشون میذاره درس میده بهشون و زنگ میزنن که تشکر کنم، اما اون موقع میفهمم مردم در مورد بسیج چی فکر میکنن.
In many ways the Iranian Basij are no different than American veterans who are seen and respected as heroes. However, unlike American veterans, these Iranian soldiers are using their image as protectors of the nation to become an economic and political force inside the country and to spread their own cultural values to the rest of the population.
اون کاری که آمریکایی‌ها الان دارن تو عراق میکنن، ما نذاشتیم عراقی‌ها بیان با ما انجام بدن. مشکل هست اقتصادی، خب زندگیه دیگه، زندگی مشکل زیاد داره، ولی اون مشکل امنیتشون دیگه وجود نداره، چون بمبی نیست، خمپاره‌ای نیست، جنگی نیست، و اینا اونایی که نذاشتن.
One of the most disturbing images to come out of Iran has been of a young woman named Neda Aga Sultan. No one is sure who shot her, but many blame the Basij. And while other Iranians have been killed during the protests, because of the viral nature of this video, Neda has become a symbol of the unrest and considered a martyr for the cause, especially on the internet, where the clip has been passed around and re-edited into tribute videos, making Neda's name into a watchword for the demonstrators. Now, this shows how technology has played a huge role in revealing what's going on in Iran, anything from YouTube to Twitter, Facebook, in and out of the country. After the break, we'll speak to Yasmin Vesuvian about the role of technology and much, much more. We're back and very close to the end of this Iran underneath the headlines. Now, I spoke with current contributor Yasmin Vesuvian, who produced many of the pieces that you just saw in this show, about what's been going on in Iran and the role young Iranians are playing in the events. Hi, Yasmin. How are you?
Hi, Mariana. How are you?
Have you been in touch with family and friends there in Iran?
I have young cousins that live there, as well as family members, and two of which recently came to the United States. So I spoke to them a couple days ago about what was going on there. Everything that's being said is actually happening, and it's not just young people. And I think what we're used to seeing is young people in Iran, because, you know, 60-some-odd% of the population is under the age of 33. But it's not just young people. That's what's so insane, is that it's young people, it's old people, it's rich, it's poor. And they were even saying clerics were out in the streets protesting. Now, the thing is that we didn't see a lot of coverage like from smaller rural areas, which is where Ahmadinejad has his core support. And when I did my piece in 2005 on Ahmadinejad's election, I went to the rural areas to find his voters. But we did still see protests in cities like Shiraz and Isfahan, which are both, you know, mid-sized cities in Iran. And then also, obviously, the main stuff that we were seeing was in Tehran.
There's also been reports about the role of women, that they've been leading the fight. Is this surprising to you?
No, I mean, not at all. 70-some-odd% of university students are women. Now, obviously, women are lacking the rights that they need or that they want in Iran. And so that's their leading the charge, because they're seeing that Mousavi may be able to provide for them those rights that they feel like they need and they want. And the thing is that as outsiders, you know, what we see is that headscarf. We're like, well, they need to just get rid of that headscarf. They must be fighting so they don't have to wear that headscarf anymore. Well, that's not the case. I mean, the headscarf is like the least of their issues. You know, they deal with things like they have to ask their husbands in order to get passports.
Are you hopeful for the future of Iran?
I'm definitely hopeful for the future of Iran. I think there's so much talent. Obviously, I think that we've shown in the way that they're connected through the web with Twitter and with Facebook. I mean, that's unbelievable. Are you kidding? These guys master Twitter, master Facebook, you know, they're all over it. There's just so much potential for Iran to have to restore relations with the United States, to restore relations with the world. I think they have a lot to offer, and I think the world has a lot to offer Iran.
What do you think is the biggest most common misunderstanding when it comes to Iran?
My point in making the videos that I did for Current is kind of showing like the similarities that exist between young Iranians and the rest of the world, and how we can relate to one another. Because ultimately, if we can find, you know, common ground, maybe we can get along better. And, you know, little Yasmins at 10 don't have to deal with, you know, ridicule.
Well, Yasmin, thank you so much. It was a fantastic interview, and you've been doing a great job with all the pieces that you've contributed to Current. Thank you so much
thank
for
you.
This time.
Thanks, Mariana. Good talking to you.
Of course, the situation in Iran is ongoing and very far from being resolved, and we will be following it every step of the way. Go to current.com/news, where you can stay up to date and get involved with our Iran coverage. Thank you so much for watching, and we know you'll join us in keeping the safety and welfare of all Iranians in your thoughts.